We introduce the topic of evolution by asking the question, how is human skin color inherited? Consider the skin pigmentation of biracial individuals. Can these phenotypes be interpreted as a simple example of dominance? Do you think that dark pigmentation is due to a dominant allele or a recessive allele? So think about it. Each of these celebrities is lighter than one of their parents. Do you think light skin could be dominant? And consider the case of a family with two sons, one dark-skinned and one light-skinned. Both parents are biracial, yet one of their sons has a very different skin tone than either of their parents or their brother. In the story of Desiree's baby, the son of Desiree and Armand had darker skin than either of the parents. Since both Desiree and Armand are light-skinned, again as in the celebrity photos we saw before, can we consider the light-skinned allele to be dominant? Before we decide on what genotype determines light skin color based on anecdotal evidence, let's think about a much larger sample size. This well-known work of art by Byron Kim shows the diversity of human skin color tones. Each panel is 10 inches by 8 inches. And the painting fills an entire wall. The colors on the panel represent 275 different skin tones. These are people that Kim met. The title of his painting, Synecdoche, means a part standing for the whole. So here the panels represent skin tones of mankind. You can visit the link on this slide to hear the artist's own words about this painting. If skin color is expressed by a dominant allele in a single gene pair, we would not observe such a diversity of skin color variations. The only skin colors observed would be dark and light. And if skin color was a case of incomplete dominance, we would observe only three skin tones, light, dark, and medium. What other possibility is there? The trait must be polygenic, a trait determined by more than one gene. To get the variety of skin tones as seen in the painting, there must be several genes for skin color, but we will limit it to three genes, A, B, and C. Remember, each gene has two alleles or alternate forms, a dominant allele, uppercase A, B, or C, and a recessive allele, lowercase A, B, and C, coding for light skin. The genotypes for each can be homozygous dominant, represented here by uppercase letters AA, BB, CC, heterozygous as in AA, BB, and CC, or homozygous recessive as represented by two small A's, two small B's, and two small C's. Here are three possible genotypes that could be inherited. The individuals with the darkest skin would all have dominant alleles. Individuals with intermediate skin would have a combination of dominant and recessive alleles. And those with very light skin would have all recessive alleles. Remember, each individual in this example would have three genes, each with two alleles. Diploid means two of each gene. In this 64-box Punnett square from the case study Desiree's baby, we can see that the trihybrid parents, that is the parents with unlike alleles for all three genes, could produce eight different gametes. Every possible combination of A, B, and C. And they would have many possible offspring with many different skin tones. But note that some of these combinations are repeated. With these three genes, there are many combinations of letters, producing seven different skin color shades represented by the different colors in this table, each having a different number of dominant alleles. Note that the offspring might have no dominant alleles, shown in the table as zero dominant alleles, and would be very light in color. The lower the number of dominant alleles, the lighter the skin. Not all of them have the same probability of occurring. The number above each genotype in each box refers to the number of dominant alleles this potential offspring would have. The offspring are most likely to have the same skin color as both of their parents. That is 3 dominant alleles out of 6. But the probability of having 3 out of 6 dark skin alleles is only 20 out of 64. The offspring can also be darker than their parents, that is, have much more than 3 dominant alleles, as seen in 22 of the 64 boxes, those with 6, 5, and 4. Finally, the offspring can have a lighter skin color than either of their parents, as seen in 22 out of 64 boxes as well. And those would be the numbers 0, 1, and 2. There is only a 1/64th chance that they would have very light or very dark skin. A 22 out of 64 chance they would have lighter skin than their parents, which is 1 plus 6 plus 15. Or a 22 out of 64 chance they would have a darker skin than either of their parents. Again, 1 plus 6 plus 15. And a 20 out of 64 chance they would have similar skin color as their parents. This may be confusing, so let's take a look at it on a graph. In this bell-shaped curve, we can see that the most likely genotype for the offspring to inherit is the same genotype of the parents. That is 3 dominant alleles. They are less likely to have more dark alleles or more light alleles than either of their parents. We will explore some possible genotypes for each of these characters in the Desiree case study in class.